How's it going, Dazzlers? Welcome back to Daz Games, and we're back with Daz Watches Kickstarters. We haven't done this in a while, and I thought it was time to go back to it. But before we get into today's video, side rant! I don't really read comments on YouTube, because most of the time, it's just bots and fake verified accounts telling me how amazing I am. So they get people to follow them back. But I do occasionally go and scroll down on them. Couple of things that I want to clear up. It was just on my last video with Dave. I don't know where it came from. I had about 4 comments. It's not a lot. I know it's not a lot. I should have just left it, but you know, I can't. Saying, oh, Daz doesn't look like he's enjoying this anymore. Such a shame. Bitch, I live for this shit. You'll never see me, like all these other YouTubers, be like, guys, I've just got to take a break because social media and all its drama, it just gets to you after a while. And I've been making videos for years now and I've never had me time. And I just feel like, shut up! We make bazillions for sitting in a chair and talking to a camera. Shut up! Obviously, I'm not judging people for how they handle their mental health, right? They can do what they want. But I love this. I love this. If I ever look tired, right now, I'm suffering with hay fever. My eyes, I look like I've just woken up. I'm aware of this. I'm not here to always look beautiful. I'm not a beauty vlogger. Even though I am stunning. The energy can't always be there. Sometimes I just want to sit down and play a fucking game. But no, I love this. I don't know where these comments came from, but I love this. I feel very privileged to wake up and, you know, when times get hard, I don't want to make a video with violin music behind me saying, ah, I just need a break. Fuck off. People who complain about doing this for a living don't deserve to do this for a living. If the shit hits the fan in real life, I don't need a break. I actually need to do more of this. This is where I come and heal. I edit and, you know, make these videos and I make everyone laugh. It makes me feel better and I need this. So I don't know. Dazzlers be slipping, okay? That's really it, really. That's the only thing I wanted to clear up. There was also another comment. One comment, right? And they were like, oh... Another Dazzler's like joining in. She's like, ah, it's so sad to see Daz's channel dying. I've got itchy, irritated eyes, and even I can see. This is the most active and most successful Daz Games has ever been. It just keeps going up. What are you talking about? Look at my main channel. Look at it. Look at these views. Look at them. 1.1 million. Daz Watches gets over 1 million every time. What are you talking about? My Ghost series is nearly capping out at 1 million. Look, 600k, million, 500k, 1.2 million. That's a game. 500k, 2.5 million. What are you talking about? This is just in the last week. Linda! Find their IP addresses. Listen. All jokes aside, right? This is why I don't read comments, because you just get some twat. They're just trying to make out that, you know, you're shit. And if you think I'm shit, why are you here? Go. The channel is doing amazing, and everything that you guys and the feedback I'm getting on the whole, 99% is that you guys love this. And the one that got me the most is because it was 4 different people saying it. Maybe my energy was off in that video. I don't know. But, like, don't come at me saying I don't enjoy this, because that triggers me. This is my passion. I love this. I love it. And that being said, let's get on with today's video, because I should just stay away from hate comments. I don't deal with it too well. Kickstarters. We all know Kickstarter. If you have a fun project in mind that no one else wants to fund, you go online and convince people otherwise. Here on Daz Watches, we react to some of the most diabolical things. But a lot of the devices in today's video could actually be good. We're here to judge, people. The first one is called Popoir. Popoir. I don't know how to pronounce that. A quantum leap in self-cleaning litter box. It's an artificially intelligent shit box for cats. That's the translation. Let's give it a watch. I'll tell you what, like, I know. So one of the reasons I don't really want a cat is because their shit smells so horrific. Oh God, even now, I'm trying not to gag. That looks like a printer. Is that a litter box? Looks like Elon Musk shit that out. Can't even fit in it, look. I've been in some toilets and some questionable bars that are that big. Alright, so the cat uses it like a normal litter tray, craps in the litter. How does it clean? What? Look, even the cats are impressed. I mean, I wouldn't have it there. That's right in front of the couch. No one's gonna have it there. That, do you know what? I was expecting a horrific invention. That's genius. That's amazing. My only concern is that I know my friends. And you just know someone's gonna get drunk at a house party and shit in your litter box. You know it. You know it's coming. That's genius. But I'm wondering why there's no like narration. There's no voiceover. This advert needs a powerful voice. Hold on, let me try.
Are you tired of your house smelling like shit? Why is it always woman picking it out? Get yourself a husband.
It's only woman cleaning it out. I don't know what's going on. Wait, no, let me try again.
Are you a woman without a man that will be willing to clean up after your cat? Divorce him.
Oh, no, let me, I'll try to be serious now.
Introducing the Poopler times 5. We've made 4 others and they accidentally killed the cat, but this one works. Your cat simply hops into the box like a normal litter tray. He may look scared, but don't worry. His shit should be the one that is scared. It's a self-sustaining, artificially intelligent shit scooper. Just look at how impressed they are. Your cats can sit on it, sit around it, and you have more time in the day to do absolutely fuck all but torture your cat with what looks like a toilet brush. It's 24 inches long, and as we know, your husband could never compete. This frees up more time for you to do yoga. Remember when you couldn't do yoga because you were too busy cleaning up after your cat? Well, this fucking thing will do the job for you. Look, she's doing yoga whilst that thing turns into a baby's cot.
Hire me. Kickstarter, hire me. I'm available. All right, I'm going to give this one a solid 10 out of 10. That's brilliant. That is brilliant. I now can get a cat because I don't have to deal with the shit. All right, next one. I just saw this and I don't know. This one's called 8-inch ice cream sandwich frog plush. I don't know what to say. Let's watch it. Oh. That was it. You want me to donate money so you can fondle a frog? I'm not here for it. What was that? That was shit. That was it. That is the product. And it's already raised £365. You know, costs of living is going up in this country, right, in the UK. It's diabolical. I should just make shit toys and molest them on camera for money. Apparently, that's what people want to see. Next! I give that a solid 1 out of 10, purely because the spank. Just put a lot of effort into the spank. This next one confuses me. It's called a duvet made of oyster shell. What? How'd you make a duvet out of an oyster shell? How was it done? Need to know. No, I'm sorry, I'm not having it. There's no way oysters make that. There's no way.
Sarah P, a duvet made of oyster shell.
A duvet.
Wow, Puss in Boots has got a new job.
A duvet.
After years of experiments, Sarah P has finally transformed discarded oyster shells into something.
I hate this when they get in like actors to be fake scientists. look at that chain. You know he works at CEX on the weekend. He's not a scientist.
Valuable by developing Smarwarm.
A new- oh, what? Swaworm. What's that?
Fiber, which has two-in-one functions of being both eco-friendly and functional.
No, I'm sorry! I don't understand how an oyster shell makes a duvoir! I don't understand it!
Every strand of smarworm retains the marine calcium in oyster shells, which has porous properties and active oxygen.
Great, so when my friend stays over now, I've got to give him a blanket that smells of the ocean. They'll love that.
To filter out the odors of bacterial mites. Even after multiple washes, it still offers long-
See, look at that! Apparently that's oyster! That's an oyster! No, my mind can't wrap around that. I want to see it. I want to see it with my mind.
Lasting antibacterial action. Smarworm absorbs infrared rays to transfer heat, thereby promoting blood circulation on the human body.
It swallows rays? There's technology in a blanket now. Can I watch Pornhub on it?
It is equally warm as down material, but four times lighter, offering a
Alright, so we're essentially now sleeping in what Peter Parker uses in his wrist shooter. Okay. Well, I'm going to give that a solid 5 out of 10 because I don't trust it. I don't feel like it's real. I feel like they're lying to us. Until I'm there and I see how they make an oyster into a blanket, I'm not believing it. I'm sorry. I'm open-minded, but I'm not that open-minded. The next one really confused me. It's called Scoring the End. This man wants money for his performance play. I'm all about plays. Love plays. Let's give it a watch, see what it's about.
Hi, my name is Rodney Murray.
Hi, Murray!
I am an artist and dancer based in Philadelphia, and I am making a new performance work titled Scoring the End. So Scoring the End is really a meditation on meaning and how we construct meaning through creative labor.
I want to punch him already. God, the pretentiousness just oozes.
And, you know, the configuration of artistic practice in everyday life.
You're rolling around in a warehouse! Nothing you said means anything that I'm watching.
I remember shortly before and then during this time of the pandemic, starting to have this fear that
I've got to spend money on watching you have a stroke in a warehouse. I hate when people can just think they can call anything art, right? I'm sorry, not everything is art. When I look at a painting, right, and I have to, and I keep finding things all the time about it that I love, that's art. When I look at a building and I can't comprehend how it was done, that's art. A man in a warehouse with glasses made out of driftwood, that's not art. It's not even good dancing. He's just doing what he wants.
I started to fear that, you know, this kind of economy that collapses academia and performance.
He's just fallen over onto a microphone. What's he doing?
This work is...
Oh my God. Imagine when I do my next tour and you will pay good money to see it and I come out on stage and I'm like... Great, I just spent 100 quid watching a man try and swat an invisible fly. No, I'm sorry, I'm out. I'm out. I'm out! That's a 2 out of 10. Because I respect the grind. It's a 2 out of 10. Alright, this next one excites me. This is next level shit. And I will remind you that they have already raised 1.6 million. 1.6 million. I'm not even going to say anything. Just watch this. And I'm moist. listen. It's already a 10 out of 10. Don't want to hear anymore, right? Send me one. Look at this shit. This is next level. This is Ready Player One. This is Ready Player One level, all right? God, like, can we watch that spin again? Imagine it.
Daz Watches C2 is a first ever all-action VR treadmill designed for gamers to overcome the immersion-breaking compromises rooted in traditional VR locomotion.
Yes, daddy, yes. Porn will never be the same again. Can you imagine watching it in this, in the 360 mode? You'd be like, there's so many dicks! Ah! Oh! Get away from me! Oh God! You know someone's gonna try it. Oh God! Never a dull moment here.
Especially motion sickness and limited physical space. It also enables the missing ways of intuitive human VR interactions.
It has a seat as well, so you can just pull it down and use it as a seat and spin around. This is amazing. I want it yesterday. I'm sorry. I've seen the future. I'm actually going to reach out to this company because I want to play Cooking Simulator in this. Imagine it. Imagine me walking around the kitchen in this. It has to be done. Love that shit. That was a straight up 10 out of 10. Need it in my life now. I really feel like we should invent something, you know? We have a big platform here on Daz Games. It's time to invent something. What shall I invent? Tea that never gets cold. That would be cool. It's amazing how we are moving into the future with technology, and yet YouTube can't remove spam bots. All right, guys! I hope you enjoyed today's video. It's been a while since we've done one of these. The only one I really want, other than I want the kitty little one, to be honest, but I don't own a cat. I just want it. I want the VR. I want that VR now in my room. Let me know what you think, guys, of all today's gadgets. What ones would you buy? What ones would you leave? Like, love, caress my channel, and I'll see you in the next one. Stay dazzling.